Hi, I'm Cheryl Bernard. I'd like to introduce you to John Morris, longtime friend, Olympic gold medalist from 2010 in Vancouver, and one of the very good-looking guys in the sport of curling.
As Cheryl said, I'm Johnny Mo. I get to introduce the wonderful Cheryl Bernard, also one of the best-looking gals in Canada and the world for curling. We had the pleasure of playing with Cheryl at the 2010 Winter Olympics. Today what we're going to do with you guys is just take you through a little bit of the basics of curling. We're going to do a little bit of strategy and then have some fun with you at the end and maybe do some situational stuff. So looking forward to working with you.
Well, first and foremost, we just wanted to take you through some of the equipment and the ice out here. This is a curling stone. They're made of granite, and the basic object of the game is to get into the hack and get this stone 150 feet down the rink into the forefoot. Now these stones, I think I said, are 42 pounds of granite, and the granite comes from Scotland.
And speaking of Scotland, there's been a long-standing debate as to where curling has originated, and we like to say that curling originated in Scotland, but it was mastered in Canada. But that's still up for debate. So, and we're going to take you a little bit through about how ice works, curling ice works, because everyone often asks, you know, what is with curling ice? It looks a little bit different than hockey ice per se. And the difference with curling ice is it has pebble on it. And what pebble is small droplets of water that are on the surface of the ice, which create the surface between the rock, which is this running surface here, and the actual ice, which is little drops of pebble. And the pebble, what it does is creates a lot less friction between the rock and the ice. So that pebble allows the rock to go down the ice with less effort. So if you were throwing this rock on a hockey rink, you'd have to throw it very, very hard to even move it about 20 feet. Whereas on curling ice, because of the pebble, you can throw it 150 feet with a lot less effort.
So one of the biggest pieces of equipment and most important is the slider for the curlers. Most of them are made of Teflon. This is a curling slider, and this is again similar to the curling stone. This is what we propel ourselves down the sheet with and what we slide on. So important thing, which is why we keep a gripper on it, is that stepping onto the ice surface, you've got something solid so you don't take a header. So, you know, this is the hack here, and this is how we basically position ourselves to slide down the sheet on this slider. And I'll just give you a sample of the delivery.
So we're just gonna go into a little bit of the scoring with Cheryl here now. Just for you folks that have never curled before, it's very similar to lawn bowling or shuffleboard per se. It's a little bit different than that, but Cheryl can take us through.
Now, these are what you call the curling rings and the scoring area. So it's the 12 foot and the 8 foot, 4 foot, and the button. And the object really is simple at the end. It's whoever is closest to the button scores the points, or multiple points as it could be. So in this case here, the closest to the button is red, even though there's two yellow. So red scores one after the completion of this end.
And the key there that you said, it's at the completion of the end. So a lot of the strategy with curling is not to get here right away. It's to set up the shot so that at the very end, your third and your skip can get the ones closest to the button.
I think curling's a little bit like chess on ice. You're always trying to think one step ahead of your opponent and negotiate to score at the end of the end.
That's why sometimes after a curling game, now that I'm skipping in the house, my head hurts because I've been thinking way too much about the curling strategy.
Join the crowd.
The reason the game's called curling is because the rocks actually curl going down to the other end of the ice. So you can't actually make them go straight. It's almost impossible. So Cheryl, what we're going to do is we're going to do a couple of in-turns and a couple of out-turns each. And the out-turn, you'll see our coach down at the other end. He's holding the broom for the out-turn. So you'll notice Cheryl's handle is pointing towards about 3 o'clock. And when she lets it go, she'll be
12 o'clock.
Towards 12. So give us a go.
Okay, and then some good sweeping here, John.
All righty. Well. I'll do my best. Pretty good.
Hard.
How's the line, coach? Weight's good?
Oh, good, sweet.
Have you done that before?
Once in a while. So the in-turn is the opposite of the out-turn, where you're starting at 9 o'clock and going to 12 rotations. So it's the same thing, just the opposite, and
see how it goes. Back ring.
great sweep, John. The two shots that I just threw were draw shots. So basically, it's draw weight, and you're trying to get the rocks to the rings at the other end. John's going to demonstrate hits now.
The takeout is another really important shot in curling. And it's the only difference with the takeout is you put your foot a little bit higher here, and you're going to drive out of the hack like you're coming out of a starting block as like a sprinter. And you get a bit more weight behind the rock. And again, because we're throwing the ice on pebbled ice, you don't have to throw it really, really heavy, because you let the pebble do the work and the rock do the work. All right, so this is an outturn hit. Let's see if we can get these rocks.
This is a shot, a takeout shot that is called around the horn. People love it because the rock basically comes off of this one, redirects back up, and that's why they call it around the horn. It's kind of around and up, and it's a triple takeout.
And if it wasn't for this rock here, we would never be able to access the button here. So this rock, we're going to use it as an aid to kick it back up, and we're sort of defying physics here a little bit. So
right.
Hammond McMillan had one of the most famous ones ever. He did around the horn to win a world championship. So we're going to try it on the Glencoe ice here.
See how it works. Sounds good.
A little less. Here we go. Yep.
Nice.
So that's just a few fun shots we had for you. And again, curling has come a long way. You know, they used to not have a free guard zone, and every rock you shot was pretty much takeouts. And now there's some draws, great draws involved, a lot of finesse. And you got to be fit and athletic to play this game. So
a lot more strategy, a lot more interest in the game, and I think it brings more crowds and people to watch it.
But we still haven't lost the social aspect of the game.
No.
So why don't we go have some lunch?
Sounds good. Let's do it, John.
All right.